Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Okay, so this will be a new chapter. It's called Subsidence. And as I told you yesterday, rock mechanics subject without telling subsidence is pretty much incomplete. So at least in the next two class, today and the next week one class, I will try to give you some idea. Hello. Somebody should mute your microphone.
Bank pe nahi tha. Bank pe nahi tha.
Okay. Now the subsidence are basically the results of what we are doing in underground.
Now subsidence.
You can mute your this thing.
Whoever
is there.
Yeah, the local one. Sir, local one. Okay,
you can mute your. Yeah.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. So subsidence is nothing but the results of what you are doing in underground. Okay. Remember that it is not the cause. Cause is something else. Cause is like we are doing excavation in underground. Or it can be naturally occurring. Like you, if you visited any caves, big caves, and if you observe that on the surface, you will see that is a subsidence. Okay. So those are naturally occurring. Subsidence can occur by excessive withdrawal of water. Groundwater, like in Delhi region, people have noticed that the ground has depressed, and that is due to there is no mining there. Okay, but this is because of excessive withdrawal of water from underground. Subsidence also occur from very deep seated deposits, like withdrawal of oil and gas. Even from 2 kilometers below, okay, subsidence can occur because you are disturbing the rock layer above whatever you are doing. Let's say if I am doing coal mining, I am making a void. So it is natural that the surface or the strata above will fail, and gradually it will be coming to the surface. Now, definitely. As the depth increases, the effect of subsidence on the surface will be less, but there will be some. So subsidence of many types. One is called trough, like this. It is occurring here. Just a minute. Like here, but it is not coming though. And there may be a hole just coming here. I am going to tell you about this. There may be just a hole coming here. So, like this is trough, and there may be a hole. Okay. Something has happened and gradually it will go. We call it sinkhole. I'll tell you later also. And this is a trough. You see, just a trough is formed. Trough is just like a karai. Okay. It is in that shape. See, this is a famous thing in UK. This is not happened due to earthquake. Okay, this happened because of the ground depression. And many cases in India also, there is many cases happen because of the underground excavation. Surface has depressed, and this is a very common phenomenon. Another type is subsurface caving. As I told you, this is very natural. Okay, cave is formed here, and this is naturally formed. Okay, natural cave. Okay, this is a very natural cave, But because it become void here, so the surface above may someday suddenly collapse. If any of you visited Bora Cave in from Vizag to that side, where is that?
Araku Valley.
If you go in that direction, there is a thing called Bora Cave. It's a huge cave. One must go and see how naturally a cave can form such a big cave. There are many other caves are there which are naturally formed, and the Bora Cave is one of them. Okay. So if you have an opportunity to go there, you go. It's a very interesting place. So that can also cause subsidence, and that is not naturally. There is no, you know, job of mining engineer. They have not done anything. We are not the culprit. Okay. Then we come to another type of this. It's called plug caving. You know, this is a very, you have probably seen this many places. Even recently, recently meaning maybe about 1.5 years ago, if you remember, in Indonesia or somewhere, or Malaysia, I forgot actually the place, some kids were playing and they suddenly enter into a something like this. And then the rescue people went. It took about 7-8 days. So it is like a cave, but that one is pretty big. It was connected towards the underground water system, and they were, since they were kids, so they could slip into that, and that is basically a plug cave. Sometime it may cave completely, or sometime it may not cave, because the cave's area is already plugged, means some portion is collapsed, and as a result maybe it has been partially filled. But nonetheless, this probably you have seen somewhere. This kind of, that is also naturally made. The human has nothing to do in this mostly, but it may also happen due to excessive withdrawal of water or other thing. And lastly, that this is that sinkhole what I was talking about. You see, in middle of nowhere, suddenly you will see a huge hole has formed. Okay, and then you know that something was eating away or already taken away in underground, and this is the results. And sinkhole may come after 100 years, after 200 years. It's may not come immediately. Okay. So these are all part of subsidence. Okay. These are all, this is like a sinkhole. The gradually it forms, and suddenly you see in the on the surface a hole is formed. Especially it happened if it's the very shallow depth. This depth is too low, then it may happen. It's a very, maybe within 100 meter. Okay. If it is within 100 meter, it may happen. Okay. And it may happen after many times. So there may be tough type of subsidence, subsurface caving, a plug caving, partially filled, and a chimney type. We call chimney, funneling, sinkhole, piping. It has many names. Okay, so these are the, always remember that these are the results of something we have done in underground, either man-made or natural. And because of that, we see something on the surface, some ground depression, either in the form of trough, or in the form of hole, or in the form of crack, or anything. okay, so which will cause this upset. Now I am going to concentrate here mainly on this trap type of subsidence, and especially due to one type of mining method, which is long arm mining. Okay. So since you are not yet exposed to long arm mining, you will be exposed next year in your third year. Let me give you a little bit idea of it, because that you can hear that. You can see this. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Something has happened in my computer. Okay, good. See, this is the coal we are going to mine. Okay, this is somewhere in underground, and this is, if you see from the top, so this is, let me go again. So this is the panel we call panel. This is the same panel. Okay. Top. Now this is the coal we are cutting here by some machine, which will be here, and this is cutting, and in the behind the rocks are falling down. And since the rocks are falling down, because we are creating this void, this may be, this is the height, this may be about, let's say, 3 to 5 meter maximum. Okay. And this height we are cutting for a width of, this width of about 150 meter to say about 300 meter. Okay. So you can see now, and this length may be, this length here, this length may be about 2 to 3 kilometers. So you can see the huge amount of void which you are creating by mining this coal. So definitely, as this mining is progressing this way, the rock here, the from the above, from the roof, it will fall down here. And those are all will be broken. Now this is showing here. We normally call it GOAF, G-O-A-F. Okay, where is the broken rock falls? All right. So this is the long arm mine. Now, because of that, this void and the broken rock, we will gradually see. The ground will be depressed, and this ground depression will cause the subsidence on the surface. So you'll see something suddenly a trough type of subsidence on the surface. So what is the maximum area it can happen? Now, if this is the panel what I shown, and let's say this entire thing is mined out, I have taken this entire panel, I have mined out, I have taken it out. So this is what is shown here. This is what is shown here. The entire panel is mined out here. So it is the broken rock, or we call it mined out long wall panel. Now, does the subsidence only restrict to this much? No way. Okay, it extend beyond this, okay, beyond this mined out area. So it may, the effect of this ground depression may be a elliptical shape like this. So this, there may be a subsidence basin like this, and in the longitudinally we can also have this. This is that mined out area. So this entire thing, this elliptical shape area, we call subsidence basin. Okay, this entire thing we call subsidence basin. Now let's say if somebody's house is here. Okay, let me take another color. Somebody's house is there, so he will also be affected. although he is not directly, his house is not directly above this, but still he will be able. But if somebody's house is here, he may be safe. Okay? So we must know what is this total area it can form. And we should warn the people that we are going to take this coal out, so your house will be affected. So normally the mining company give compensation and ask them to, or they request them to leave. So they call the project affected people. Now the compensation is not so bad. They give good compensation. But if there is any structure, why house, any structure above that subsidence basin, then there will be an effect on that structure. Okay, that's what you must know. Now, what this subsidence basin depends on, if I come back to the rock mechanics point of view, it's the mainly the physical and geomechanical properties of the roof and the strata. Okay, physical and geomechanical property meaning its strength, its toughness, its joint properties, you know, its RMR, its GSI, all these type of properties are very important here. So we must know these properties. Then we must understand that whether the overburden, I will show you in the next the overburden, the above this coal seam, that means whatever the rock layer above here, whether they are strong and hard, means we can divide it into two parts. One is right above the coal seam and another is way above. And whether they are strong hard or strong hard and weak soft. This is the most vulnerable condition. So that's why this geomechanical property is very important. Okay, we have to find this to understand all these strata above, how they are, okay, what is their property. Second point is the mined out opening. That means that I gave you here that this may be 2 to 3 kilometer, 150 to 300 meter, and this will affect the size of this this mined out area will affect the subsidence. Now sometimes this subsidence basically restrict the mining also. Even I can tell you, even yesterday a company visited us. They will start a new mine, underground mine, coal mine, and they wanted to do the subsidence analysis. So see, this is very basic. Now if you want to start a coal mine or any mine for that matter, you have to submit your subsidence plan, mitigation plan, to the government, because your project affected people, you have to understand that they are real people. They have houses maybe over the many years. Their grandparents used to live there. He may be born in that house, he or she. Then it is not so easy to convince the people, please leave, we will do mining. Okay, it is not so easy. So that's why the company has to submit a proposal, a plan, what they are going to do. Then government decides, okay, whether to give you permission or not. And they came to us to know this, that what will be the maximum subsidence it can happen there. Okay, so that will now depend on what is the amount of, you know, excavation they will do per year. okay, how much void they are going to generate in underground. Then definitely third point will be the depth. If depth is pretty high, we can say the effect will be low. Then mining height, whether you are mining 3 meter coal seam or 2 meter coal seam or 5 meter coal seam, this is a direct effect on the amount of subsidence which can happen on the surface. I think this calculation I will do in the next class. Then the topography, that means the surface topography, whether it is a little bit hilly area or a plain area or a already depressed area, or it is a, you know, cultivated land or any water body near, you know, there I can tell you there is a uranium deposit in Karnataka, and that could not be, you know, pursued simply because there are two water bodies nearby, two lakes basically, and it was assumed that that will be affected due to this subsidence, and those water body may come directly to the mine. So it was a very interesting deposit, but it could not be touched right now, okay, because of these water bodies. So surface topography is also very important. And also the lastly is basically the time. Although it is estimated by many researchers that within a year we have 90% of the subsidence, and rest 10% happens over the years, many many years. But for sinkhole type, it may go up to 100 years. You know, in UK they have reported a sinkhole after 300 years. So you never know. And then when they dug the surface and went below, they say, oh, there is a mine over there. There was, and nobody knew that why suddenly a sinkhole has happened. Then when they went for investigation, they found it. Okay, so the mining was happened 300 years before. So the result can come after many 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 years. Okay, it is not that it will happen only you did today and tomorrow you will see the results. Now, as I told you, the fracture system over a long run, yeah.
So what is the difference between mining depth and mining height? As you have said, there are two parameters.
Oh, okay. Let me show you just here, and then you will know. Let me make it a little big. Depth is this. This is depth of the coal seam. And mining height is this. How much you are? This is the mining height. Look. How much you are mining? Okay, that means it may be the coal seam height, or it may not be the coal seam height. Coal seam height may be 8 meter, but you are mining only, let's say, 4 meter. So mining height is this: how much you are mining. Okay, you understand that?
Yes.
Okay. Now you see, this is the panel. Now let me show you which part I am saying. Now this is the long wall panel. I said this is the rectangular. You have seen that. Now we have taken a section along this vertical section along AA dash, and that is has been shown here. This picture, vertical section along AA dash. Okay. So this entire area is now mined out. We have already taken out the coal, and then what happens? Okay, this is what I am showing here. Now you see what happens here. This is the panel width. We call it panel width. Let's say W. This is what is shown is the. Now right above this will fall on this void. So this zone is called the cape zone. Immediately above the coal seam, There is an immediate roof, which is basically shale, coal combined, and maybe sometime clay also. And they immediately fall. That's why it's called immediate roof. Okay. Immediately they fall. The moment you have mined this, in the behind it falls. And nobody goes behind, so everybody is safe there. Now, those are the cave zone. And some part of the main roof, above that there may be a sandstone layer or so, that can also fall. And those are mostly broken rock. Cave zone are mostly broken rock. Okay. So this is called cave zone. Right here it is. After the cave zone, what happens is there are some rocks, or the rocks start above there, they will have fractures. And you always remember that the broken rock increases in volume. Okay. You will always see, you break anything. Let's say you break a piece of brick. Okay. And that brick was somewhere in a box. Let's say perfect. It fits in that box. You break the brick, you will never able to put it back into that box. Because there will be a lot of air pockets now, okay? And so it increases in volume. So we call that bulking factor. The volume of the broken rock, including that air space, divided by its original volume, is always more than one. So what will happen is here, this broken rock will quickly, or the cave zone will quickly fill up the void space, okay? It will quickly fill up. So the above layers will then sit on this broken rock, and it will have some fracture system. So here there will be fracture zone, okay? This is, I'm not saying just hypothetically. These people have put some well bore, they have drilled and got the core. And then they realize that this is what is happening. Okay, so this has been proven. And then they put the camera also inside here after drilling the hole, and they see that whether it is really fractured or not. Okay. So there are some part, up to some part will be fractured zone. Okay. Up to some part will be fractured zone here. And then above the fractured zone, now pretty much the rock layer has been settled down. And then there will be a continuous deformation zone, which is given here. And then finally on the surface, you will see a subsidence. This ground has depressed. Okay. And as I told you, it will not be restricted vertically. The zero subsidence will happen at some angle, and this is called angle of draw, and I will discuss that in great detail. Okay. So it goes like this. Okay. So this is what is pretty much the mechanics of rock caving above the longwall panel or any void system you have created in underground, either naturally or man-made. So this is going to happen. Now, as you are seeing, if the depth increases, definitely the effect on the surface will decrease. Okay, you will not see. But having said that, even the petroleum industry reported subsidence. Now they are pretty much afraid in some cases because they do also offshore drilling, right? Like in Bombay High or so, these are offshore drilling. So in the seabed, it may also subside, okay, and can form the cracks and this thing. And their the entire system, their that rig and everything is on that. Although that may be sometime anchored in the sea, or sometime it just float on the sea. But nonetheless, that effect may come on that rig also. If the subsidence happen, suddenly the water will go down, further down. So that may affect the locally in that area. So they also do, petroleum industries also do subsidence analysis. Remember this. Not only mining. Although the majority blame comes to mining people, because it's pretty visible that we are digging something and suddenly surface has subsided. Okay. So people take us to court. It's a very common thing due to subsidence. Us means to the mining company. And mining company knows what to do with this. Okay. That's why in the very beginning, they want these people to leave with compensation so that they do not face any difficulty while they do mining. Okay. You remember that. Why I'm saying or repeating this, that you cannot avoid subsidence when you are doing something in underground. Okay. Nobody can. So we have to deal with it. Okay. Just like we are stuck with corona, similarly we are stuck with subsidence. Okay. The mining people are stuck with subsidence. There is no coming back from this. Now we come to some definitions before going into, you know, the calculations. So I thought first you must understand some basic definitions. What is subsidence and the associated terminologies? You see, although I have drawn it here, see, there is a point A here. I'm not sure whether you are able to see. Let me just check. Let me draw this. Let's say this is a flat, this thing. And this is, I'm drawing this thing here. Now, the ground, let's say there was a point here A. Oops, this software is giving problem. Let's say there was a point A here. Now, if my subsidence basin is something like this, this point, oops, try to come in this direction. Here it is, drawing is a little difficult, so let me show it here. So this point A will come around this direction. It suddenly doesn't come only to the vertically, okay? It goes in a vector like this. Why it is so? The reason is very simple. The reason is everything tries to draw towards, all this particle is trying to draw towards the center, Everything is trying to come towards the center. You have seen that, right? In a funnel, if you drop something, some water or some, let's say sand, what happens? It's trying to come towards the center. This is a very natural phenomenon. So, a point on the surface A will try to come in this direction, towards the center. Not only vertical, also there will be a horizontal movement. So, let me now draw it properly. So let's say this come here, okay? So you can see there is a vertical movement, there also a horizontal movement, okay? Always remember that every point has a vertical movement as well as a horizontal movement towards the center. So if there is a point here, this will also try to come in this direction. A vertical movement and a horizontal. Okay. So this is going to happen. Okay. Now, you understand this movement. Now, there are basically three types of subsidence. One is called subcritical, one is supercritical, and another is called critical. The critical is a theoretical understanding. Mostly, basically, in the field, it happens either subcritical or supercritical. Now, what is subcritical and supercritical? We can do it through mathematics also. But for understanding, physical understanding, let me go in long haul this thing. The physical understanding of subcritical and supercritical subsidence. Now you see this panel here. This has certain width and certain length and certain mining height. Okay, this is that mining height here. Okay. So it has a width like this, it has length going like this and the width. Now, because of this width and the length L, this length L, and depend on its depth and the rock layer on above the coal seam, there may be a maximum possible subsidence. Now, can anybody tell me what could be the maximum possible ground depression it can happen? What is the maximum? If the mining height is M, some less than 3 meter, mining height is 3 meter, what could be the maximum ground depression it can happen? How much you can see on the surface? Maximum. If we are mining 3 meter height, what could be the maximum? Can you hear me? Yeah, 3 meter, right? Okay. So the maximum possible is 3 meter. But definitely it will never happen. As I told you, the rock increases in volume. So it will never happen then. But even if that's, having said that, there may be 2.7 meter or 2.5 meter, that is the maximum possible it can have. Now, I already gave you, this depends on all these parameters here, whatever I gave. It depends on these parameters, that what could be the maximum possible subsidence. Okay? This depends on all these parameters. So if you are doing a 3 meter mining height, let's say M is 3, so subsidence maximum, I may get about 2.5 meter or so. Okay, I may get 2.5 meter or so. And that is the maximum it can happen because of these conditions. Because of these conditions, the maximum may be 3.5. Okay. So this is telling me due to the rock properties. Now, no matter this 2.5 meter will remain, even if I increase the width, even if I increase the width or length, the maximum possible will remain because it depends on the rock layer above it and the mining height. It's nothing to do with this geometry. This will be maximum possible on that surface. This is a very important concept. So every site, wherever we do coal mining, there will be a maximum possible subsidence, which we call S-max. And when in a particular area, we achieve that subsidence, or the maximum possible, we call it supercritical subsidence. I will show you with the mathematical equation also, maybe next class. But this is what is maximum possible. Now, let's say I made a much smaller geometry.
So,
yeah.
So if the geometry changes, then the area subsidence basin area will change. So it doesn't affect the height.
Or yeah, it does. It does. But up to a maximum level. You see, I think you have said it cannot go more than 3 meters, right? So even if I increase the area, it cannot go more than 3 meters because I am mining 3 meters. So it cannot go more than 3 meters, right?
Yes.
So even if I increase the total area, maybe 10 times, it will be maximum will be that 3 meter or let's say 2.5 meter. It will never achieve that. So in a particular area for a given mining height, the maximum subsidence is fixed. Okay. And that cannot be changed by changing the dimension of the panel, of the this panel. Okay. Now, so that is our S-max. Now let's say I have an area which is very small. This software is pretty bad. So I have an area which is much smaller. There also I will see a subsidence, maximum subsidence, but that will not be the S max. So that is called critical subsidence. There will be a maximum subsidence. We normally call it S naught, which is less than S max. That means what we are saying is we can still increase the dimension. We can still increase the dimension of the panel. Increasing the dimension of the panel means more production. Okay, but we will also increase the effect on the surface. We will go towards the maximum subsidence. Okay, when this condition happens, we call it subcritical subsidence. Means we have not reached to that critical stage yet. In India, most of the longwall panels we mine are in the subcritical zone. We have not reached to the critical zone. Other than one panel now is being mined in Adriala, which is in Singareni Colliery, which may be approaching towards that maximum subsidence or the critical or supercritical, but it still it will take some time to reach that. So you see now the difference. This is the S naught. This is for the subcritical subsidence. The maximum comes here. And you see, this is the S max. This entire zone here is S max. It will not exceed that. Okay? Only then S max area will increase if you increase the dimension. Okay? And this will remain that S max. The maximum possible it has reached. Okay, for the given mining height and for the given rock layer here. So this S max is fixed. But in the above, this is not, this is still less than S max. This has not reached towards S max. There is a subsidence, but it's not reached to the maximum. Okay. So this point should be clear to you that what is critical and what is supercritical. Okay, for using an equation you can find, but actually understanding of this is more important than the equation. Okay, now towards the definition. So as you are seeing here, the subsidence is a vector. Right, from A to somewhere in A dash it will come. So this is a vector. It has a vertical component and it has a horizontal component. Now if I can show you on 3D, there is a point, let's say this, there is a point, and this point can now go, one is vertical and one is horizontal direction. And this horizontal direction in a plane, if I draw in a plane, so it may be in this direction. Now in that plane you can do x and y direction, and the vertical, let's say the z is up this, so it may be down there. So let me draw it properly. This software is not good for drawing. So what is happening is, in a plane, it may go, you have to understand in 3D. Let's say this is x, y, and this is the z direction. So my vector is, basically vector is somewhere going like this. Subsidence vector would be like this. It has now one component in this direction and one component on this plane here. And in that plane, there may be again two directions. Okay, two perpendicular horizontal directions you can have. So this is what is in 3D. You have to understand that. But here I am taking on a section here. So in that section, it is just a 2D is showing. So one is the vertical component, one is horizontal component. Remember that the vertical component is called the subsidence. Okay? The vertical component is called the subsidence. The horizontal component is called the horizontal displacement. So we normally denote this by S, and this is by U. Okay, so subsidence is denoted by S and horizontal displacement is denoted by U. Okay, in the book the definition is clearly given, there is no ambiguity, so you can directly see. I have just copied from the book, so here, maybe later on I will share it if somebody doesn't have a book. So this is the subsidence, this is horizontal displacement. Then what is the slope? Slope is basically ds dx. X is in any this along that a dash line, that means this line, whatever